Mike Atherton, front there, capturing the side, opening the batting. And interesting to see the bowling shared between Dean Headley, Darren Goff. De Freitas back, bowled extremely well last week for Derbyshire at Lords, caught the eye there. Mark Elam got wickets last week, two against Glamorgan. And Robert Croft, Glamorgan off-spinner, makes up the bulk of the bowling with Holyoake standing by with medium pace.
Missed it by a whisker. So an airy-fairy start for Mark Waugh. Darren Goff with a very good opening over. One run came from it. He passed the bat twice. Morning. Darren Goff strikes. It's the Australian captain, Mark Taylor, who's gone. And that was a repetition of the ball he bowled at him in his first over, which just missed the outside edge. This one's just clipped it.
Yes, it cut off the seam, but it didn't bounce quite as much as the other one. He's been in great form as Darren Goff. It's not a surprise that he's made the early breakthrough.
Nothing wrong with that delivery either.
Well, that's a bit of magic, that, from Darren Goff. He's made everything nip back. And this one has just held its line, pitched off stump, and it's a beauty.
First runs off the bat for 31 deliveries. Welcome relief for Australia. And eventually...
Because Darren Goff hasn't done well, he's bowled a superb spell. My baby's two maidens, 1-6, might have had two or three more wickets. Ball going past the outside edge and then jagging back at the right-handers. It dragged him very wide, but Steve Waugh gave it some tremendous hammer there through extra cover. It's a beautiful stroke. Two strokes on the offside in the last two overs. One, a drive off the front foot from Steve Waugh, and then... wonderfully well fielded. Interesting fielding position. Atherton has set himself there. He's giving Steve Waugh full rein on the offside for the drive. Beautifully bowled. Mark Waugh was aiming away through mid-on. Perhaps even wider than that when we have a look at it on the replay. That was well bowled. An intentional Yorker. Drew the batsman into the stroke and knocked him over.
It's a little bit quicker than I think he suspected. A bit fuller. And he did play well across the line and just missed it completely. But he does... bowl one or two deliveries that just get onto the batsman quicker than they think, and I think he's done him for length and pace, and unfortunately he's played across the line as well.
There's LBW. He's run out as well, but it's not going to count. That was well bowled. That's looked from here to be the straight one. He's bowled a couple of away swingers, and that just could have taken Steve Waugh by surprise.
I thought it kept a little bit low on him. Yes, he's playing across the line again, like his brother, playing very much towards mid-wicket. It was a little out-seamer that kept low, and then you play across the line, you're in trouble here. That would have hit about halfway up the stumps.
Well, this will be four runs. Mark Elam operating with a strong offside field.
Good bit of fielding. Michael Atherton was the fielder at backward point.
Well, they're so much under pressure, they're desperate to get singles anywhere. And this is what causes problems. England have just played good pressure cricket.
Big shout there from Croft. Certainly bowled wicket to wicket, gets him very... Well, that was a little tickle. Probably a bottom edge. Croft stifled the appeal. That's a good shot. Very firm push, and that's speeding away to the boundary. Finds the gap. No slips. Flying away for four, down the hill here at Headingley.
Have to be quick. Ah, that's beautifully done. Lovely piece of fielding. Now, it's just a question of whether Bevan was fast enough to get there, but I doubt it very much. I think he's gone. I think he knows it. Umpire has called for the replay. Bevan has gone.
Well, it's not often you beat Michael Bevan, but it had to be a smart piece of fielding. Graham Thorpe coming in, pick up, cool and calculated, and run him out easily, didn't he? Super job done by Graham Thorpe.
That was a face-saving partnership for the Australians. Michael Bevan. 5 wickets down now. Darren Goff has got an inside edge. And Greg Blewett is the man to go. The partnership, 63 between Blewett and Bevan. And in the space of two balls, they've both gone.
Well, we all know that Darren Goff has a brilliant Yorker. And it was an attempted Yorker, inside edge, cannoned onto the stumps, but give the bowler the credit. He's bowled beautifully today. It was intended to get it up there. Maybe he got a little bit of luck to get the inside edge, but he won't bother about that.
Well, he'll get four for it. Didn't quite finish up where he wanted it. There's a roar from the crowd, but that was a bump ball. Oh, trouble here if it's gone to the keeper. Alex Stewart has missed. Almost had time to trot across and take the bails off. Might have been a fraction unsighted because he was half turned away from Healy.
Dropped it. Well, that was straight in, straight out, Graham Thorpe. Just in front of the umpire at square leg. Goes begging. Good stop. Michael Atherton just in closer than the normal extra cover there. By the time he's walked in and steadied himself, that cuts down the angle a bit. One ball left for Robert Croft in his allocation of 10 overs. Beautifully stopped. Well, that's been a great spell. Very fine piece of bowling indeed from Robert Croft. 10 overs straight off the reel. One maiden, but only 16 runs conceded. Could have had one wicket when Michael Slater was dropped at square leg. Well, that's a very fine spell indeed from the Welshman. What a catch! What a lovely catch from Michael Atherton. One hand was all he could get to it, but it was more than enough. Ian Healy just thought he might have got over the man, the England captain, at short extra cover. Another 3 inches higher and he would have done. But look at that. Straight in, not a problem. Well taken. Mark Elam with an even better catch to trump his captain. Never easy for the bowler to change direction just like that. That's an extraordinary catch to get rid of Michael Slater. Mark Elam doing it all himself.
Yeah, top class effort. He's just falling away and then sticks his right hand out. They are so difficult to take when they're following through. Fortunately, it was his best hand, but even so, it was still top class.
Well, that's hoiked into space, and is four. Dean Headley was out there at deep mid wicket. Didn't seem to...
Oh, well bowled again. Batsman's got it away. And they'll pick up two, so that's good cricket. Wonderfully well bowled slow ball produced a wicket. That is great cricket from Holyoake. Don't expect batsman down the order to be able to do everything the top order can, but Shane Warne has been given a little bit of his own medicine. The master of deception, and Hollyoake has just done the same thing to him.
Yes, he played far too soon. He deceived him in the air, and then it chipped up, and I think three players could have caught it in the end.
And that'll help. He'll go down as leg byes, I would think. That's an absolute beauty. Does that so well, Darren Goff.
Well, the players in the Yorkshire team say that he's back to his best, Darren Goff. He's been bowling really well, full of confidence. He fancies his chances every time he gets the ball in his hand.
That's the end for the Australians, 170 for 8, a full 50 overs. An excellent performance from England. They've taken the...
And England seamers appear to be on top. There was a promising partnership of 31 between Mark and Steve Waugh, and then a substantial partnership, 63, between Michael Bevan and Greg Blewett. Then Spanowicz and Kasparovic bowls tonight.
No ball called, and it'll go to four, racing away on the offside. Yeah! Well, it didn't look as though it could touch anything but the bat. Atherton was so far away from his pads with his bat. I imagine that the noise only had been an edge. Not quite what the England captain had in mind, because it may well have been called a wide.
Well, there are some funny ways to get out, aren't there? He's not made too many runs this year, Michael Atherton, and I think he'll be thinking that's really been strangled out. Not a particularly great delivery.
Well, they're asking there and they're getting it, because it hit the pad first and then came onto the bat. Just got inside the stroke. Ball darted back from just outside the left-hander's off stump. Looked a good decision.
Just caught him a little bit on the move, you see. When the ball hits him, he's in front. Hits him on the knee roll, and he keeps pushing the foot and the pad outside off stump, but it's too late.
He can't do that. It's on the rare occasions McGrath's given the batsman any width at all. Precisely what Stewart likes.
That's close. Just maybe going down leg side. It certainly started just as beautifully bowled. Australia celebrating. Ray Julian hasn't moved, nor has Alex Stewart. Oh, it seems that the bowl of the keeper, the slips. In fact, anyone wearing anything with a bit of green on their sweater or their cap were convinced there was an edge there. Alex Stewart at no stage offered to move.
Well, I'm not surprised. I've never seen many Australians leave the crease until the umpire gives them out. It was a very good delivery. If it was a nick, it was a very fine one, but I think it was just a good ball. And they were appealing.
Very close, and that's out. It made no difference at all, the fact the previous one wasn't given. Ray Julian's been heavily involved in this match. He's had to make decisions all the way through. He's got that one right as well, I think. Specialist one-day player, a stroke maker by nature. He comes in now in a situation where a very cool head's going to be needed. Oh, great shot. Graham thought really punched that away. On the up, but it was a short arm jab, perfectly timed.
And there's no doubt that it's the ball that's hit the stumps direct. And I think we'll find the third umpire will give him out. Smart piece of fielding there. Lovely pick up and throw.
Yeah, he really was very, very quick across the ground. And in fact, that I think is what caused Graham Thorpe.
Was just... I think Shane Warne suggesting what they might do with the loud criticism here at Headingley. Oh! They're a wonderful team, Shane Warne and Ian Healy. Wonderful combination. There's a good comparison for you after 20 overs. Not a great deal of difference, England having lost one more wicket. And England requiring 115 to win. Just under 40. Fine shot. Picked his spot. He played the ball very late indeed. Beautifully judged. That's another big hit. Very big hit indeed for... And you must say that Graham Thorpe is with the reading Shane Warne.
Hundred up, and England doing it well here in this first Texaco. That's a neat stroke. Just racing away down towards the boundary. Perfect timing.
Again, I don't know if he read it, but he's a bit more confident now, Holyoke, and he waited, and that's the clue to it. Short, and it's hooked away. Six runs. Well, he really clattered that. There was a fielder down there who looked optimistically towards the skies for a while. But Adam Holyoke must have known the moment the ball left the bat that this was going for six. His parents have come a long way to see him, all the way from Australia, and apparently their luggage has been mislaid. I wish that was an unexpected piece of news. Oh, fine shot, but fingers on that. But that could well be Holyoke's 50. Fine shot, Gillespie got fingertips on it. A noble effort to stop it, but it's obviously come out of the middle of the bat. And that's a fine performance by Adam Holyoke. 50 not out, 66 balls, his first one day 50, of course.
Into a winning position, and the zip's gone out of the Australian bowling. They know that England can see the winning post. It's just a matter of polishing off these last few runs.
That's going to race down to that fine leg boundary. That's the problem, bowling round the wicket. Jason Gillespie, if he fires too close to leg stump, anything like that. And it's quite a steep hill. That ball races down there. That's an extravagant shot from Graham Thorpe. Plenty of freedom now. Up and over the top. Successive boundaries now for Thorpe and England.
Shot, a big shot from Adam Holyoke. Six runs over mid-wicket, and that's a very, very convincing way to end this match. The first Texaco Trophy match won by England, thanks to a wonderful partnership between young Holyoke, his first one-day international, and the experienced Graham Thorpe, both from Surrey, of course. Partnership of consummate understanding, but great fight and courage. England accused so often of not having the steel in the middle of the order, produced it today. And so, as this series, this Ashes series begins, Australia taste defeat. McGrath and Gillespie and Kasprowitz all bowling extremely well. And that run out by Greg Blewett of Graham Lloyd, really effective. But then came the partnership of 130.